little bit of spoken word, and this is something that you're going to enjoy. So ladies and gentlemen, let's give a big round of applause, Mr. Joyner.
Powerful, you know, bird. That was a hawk. And the hawk said, Stop it! It doesn't belong to you. You cannot use it. It belongs to small granted. He said, who are you? He said, I am the god of small contest abode. I don't let anybody play. That man, he said, I want to play this. I want to play. He said, no. You can't play this. But you know, Africans, we like to make deals. We like to negotiate. You know, we like to negotiate, right? You go to the marketplace, you negotiate, go ahead, you negotiate, right? Right? So that man, said to him, so small contest, he said, what will I have to do? What do I have to do for you to let me play this instrument? Because I really want to play. So the punk in the rafter said, well, I have a deal for you. He said, what's the deal? He said, I want you to take an oath that from now on, whenever you see my children, the hawks, in the sky, coming down to get a cheek on the ground, you will never stop them. He said, that mother said, is that a deal? Is that all you want me to promise you that? For me to play this instrument? Small granted him. That mother said, yes. Okay, I'll take a vow. From now on, none of my children will touch your children. In fact, your name and my name will become one. Your children and my children will always become one. So the hawk said, if you agree to that, then I will let you play this bala. I'll let you play this instrument. Nakumadua was excited. He's ready to play it. He's playing. All of a sudden, in the air, in the winds, Small Rokante landed. Small Rokante. When he landed, the moment he landed, Nakumadua was trembling. He was so scared because this man is known for a nonsense man, right? He said that his shoes are made of skin of human beings. The coat that he wears is made of the skin of human beings. And here he was in front of Nakumadua. He was so scared. He started trembling. But guess what he did? Words are very, very important. That's what we started with. Kuma. That's the thing we're talking about. Kuma. Words are very important to learn. The most important thing that we can learn is words, right? So, what did that gentleman do? He said, Small Rokante, you who is the conqueror of all the earth, Small Rokante, you the one that never escorts anyone because you don't want to encounter any foolishness on the street. Small Rokante, whatever you say happens, and whatever you disagree with will never happen. Small Rokante, what do you want? Small Rokante has never heard someone praise him so much. He was taken so much by this praise. He said, oh, I didn't know that praise is sweeter in the mouth of someone else. It's better that someone else praises you than for you to praise yourself. So I want to take this occasion quickly to praise Latanya Joyner. I was so surprised. Come on, yeah. Let's give it to her, okay? Let's give it to Latanya Joyner. This is the daughter, okay? That Madame Caroline raised. Okay?
This is the daughter.
So, Small Rokante said, okay, I will let you play this bala. So, Nakumadua began to play the bala for Small Rokante. And Small Rokante loved me so much that, okay, well, from now on, I give you this bala. This is yours from now. That's how the inherited the bala What does it say? There's a song, it's a song that we've been playing, it's called Gambian. The song that they've been playing, Gambian.
Chalia,
being a poet, storyteller, being a person of the world. So, the idea in Mandate culture, of which most people in Gambia and many people in West Africa are of Mandate-related origin, we believe that royalty and artistry was indeed equal. You need both of them. You need words and you need deeds. So words and deeds are all noble. So if you are a fina, if you are a jelly, if you are a gaulo, if you are any gelwa, if you are any of those people, it doesn't matter if you are the president of the United States, you will always say, I'm jelly. See? It doesn't matter where you are. Say, for the people of Bronx, Gambian 4.
This is wonderful. This is amazing. This is beautiful. African culture is beautiful, isn't it? Yes. Let's give Africa a round of applause, please. All right. So now, at this point, you know, we've already introduced our wonderful sponsor, supporter, leader, assemblywoman, Latoya Joyner. We've already done that. Okay, so we don't need to repeat that, but we're going to do something a little bit different this afternoon. So our wonderful artist is going to introduce the assemblywoman in a special kind of way, all right? In a special kind of way, in the way that only we can do that, right? She will probably never get this kind of introduction anywhere else except back home in Africa. All right? Yes. So, ladies and gentlemen, Alhaji Salu is going to introduce our leader, State Assemblywoman Latoya. If you don't understand what he's saying, it's okay. Trust me. He's saying good things. All right? So, Alhaji Salu, over to you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Muhammad. Latoya Joyner, ensemble woman, Bronx, New York. Galore na te kane kwandom, Latoya Joyner. Bede ha Latoya. Lori ni ma. America. Joyner, Joyner.
My brother was calling Carolyn's name. He was calling Mr. Laurie's name. Okay, that's very, very important. So that's the most important introduction that we can possibly give to somebody. That's why I'm here.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yes. Thank you so much. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Assemblywoman, Latoya Joyner. Yes, let's give a round of applause.
That's probably the best introduction I have ever received and will ever get, even though I didn't understand many words, but thank you so much. And what a beautiful way to spend our Saturday evening, correct, folks, right? We didn't have to travel downtown. We could travel right in our community to enjoy beautiful culture, singing, our history, and that's what today is about, celebrating our history, our culture, and the people within our community, and most importantly, us. Right? Today we decided to do this program to, you know, recognize the importance of words, either through spoken word or written word. That is what today is about. We're encouraging people to express themselves, to communicate. And especially for our young children, I'm just so thankful to see all of them here today. Today is about them. We wanted to put on an event about, you know, spoken word and teaching kids the importance of reading. I want to thank Mama Du. He has been amazing, an amazing partnership we have started with our office. We're looking forward to doing great work with him. He's looking to start a book club for African women so that they can learn how to read with each other and to their children. And this is my fourth year of representing the community here, and like Muhammad said, we serve together on the community board. And that is the most grassroots of serving the community. It's not an elected position, it's an appointed position. So this is a position that you volunteer within the community to look out for the best interests of the community. And I just want to commend Muhammad, because a lot of issues that came up that many other people were too afraid to speak up about, he was not afraid to speak up or vote no on an issue that he thought was important for this community. So I want to thank him for his leadership. And of course, LPAC, Dr. Rivera, he has been truly amazing. Like he said before, I was even the assemblywoman. He welcomed me into his congregation and he prayed for me. And that was the best gift anyone could truly give to me, was to pray. And I thank him for continually to support me and support my staff and my office here. And, you know, I represent this district here, and this month is Black History Month. And this month, my office has been putting up different facts, historical facts, so that we can celebrate Black culture and that we can always remember that Black is beautiful. So I did want to share a fact of the day. On this day in history, Ron Brown was elected chairman of the Democratic National Committee. He was the first African American to lead a major American political party. So I did want to share that fact today, because more than ever, we need true, strong leadership, right? And especially with who we have in the White House, we need to, you know, encourage more people to get involved and stay active, because we need everybody's participation in order to, you know, make the world around us better and hold our elected officials accountable. Also, as you all know, I represent the area here, District 9, and we are in somewhat of a crisis here in District 9. We have many of the children reading below, you know, grade level. We have 3-4% proficiency level in the community, and we have to do better. And it starts with us. It starts with at home reading to our children, and also storytelling, either through oral history and written history. We have to reinforce these values within our children so that they can go into the classrooms and make our classrooms even better. Because right now, we have many schools in the area closing down because they want to put the blame on us. And instead of putting the blame on us, it's up to us to take more control of our surroundings and our community and instilling the best values we have within our children. So I did want to come up here and say thank you to everyone. Thank you for joining us and being here this afternoon. I have a list of thank yous, so I want to make sure I don't forget anyone. And I did want to talk a little bit about my position, state legislator. We vote on the budget and legislation. And just this last week, we voted on the DREAM Act. And the DREAM Act is very important because it's going to set up a fund to allow undocumented students from immigrant backgrounds, the ability to go to college and receive financial aid. We were able to pass that in the Assembly, and we're also looking forward to the Senate also passing that piece of legislation, because we can't wait for the federal level government officials to get their act together. So we're really trying on the state level the best way that we can to make sure we're providing that opportunity for our children, because at least for me, education has always been my route to doing better, my safety net, my way out. It was my ticket out. And it was also my ticket to come back to the community and reinvest my resources back here. So I'm very thankful for that. And I want to make sure that other children have that ability to do the same. We're also fighting for more funding here in the community. So let me make sure I say my list of thank yous, because I do not want to get in trouble. Wanted to start by acknowledging the African Advisory Council. We're looking forward to your leadership as well. To our musicians, our poets, our storytellers from the African Story Project, thank you so much. And again, now is more than ever important that we are in control of telling our stories. I'm not sure if many of you are aware, but the Daily News just published an article, I believe, last week, where a teacher did a demonstration about, you know, the Middle Passage and, you know, transporting Africans here and in, you know, South America, and she had the children lay on the ground and it stepped on them in order to show them what it felt like to go through that the trade over here. And it was truly, you know, disheartening that yes, we want to raise awareness, but we have to make sure we are telling our history on our terms with our words. And, you know, now more than ever, you know, the younger generation truly needs us and people like us. And I do want to acknowledge my staff, my wonderful staff who was able to put this all together and investing in new and young leadership that we have in the community. So I did want to acknowledge my hero from my office who practically put this whole thing together with Muhammad. And Muhammad, thank you so much. And wanted my hero to say a little bit of words too.
Salaam alaikum. Again, we just want to appreciate to have a boss who really appreciates your culture and allows you to interact in this way with the community and appreciate every you know, the diverse background that represents this area. So thank you again. We just want to give a few thank yous. So again, thank you to LPAC, to our musicians, Saliu, Amos, Uye, Keolin, Abdule Toure, thank you so much. Our poets, Rashida, Mama Rashida, thank you. Shannon Ross and Siobhan Ross, thank you so much. The storytellers from the African Story Project, thank you so much. And again, thank you for sharing your art. We truly, truly appreciate you being here with us this afternoon. And we're just gonna take a second and recognize the African countries that are here. So, you know, from Gambia to Guinea to Ghana to Benin, Burkina Faso, all the West African areas, thank you so much for coming. And this is what it's about, right? We have to come together. It's not about what country you're from. We came together tonight. I really, truly appreciate it. The Assemblywoman appreciates it. So thank you so much again.
Yes,
and Nigeria.